Assalamu alaikum and very good morning to everyone. Hi, I'm Anissa Akila binti On, student from Bachelor Degree of Science, Honor Science Aquatic. Today, I will present about my FYP presentation. The title for my FYP presentation is The Isolation for Species-Specific Primer of Batago borneensis Painted Terrapin Using Cytochrome C Oxidase Subunit 1, which is COI. Content that I would like to explain is my introduction. There are 14 families and 295 species of turtle in the world. 265 species inhabit in freshwater environment. IUCN, which is International Union for Conservation of Nature, lists 6 species of Batago species as critically endangered species, while sites, which is Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora, lists these Batago species in Appendix 1 and Appendix 2. Appendix 1 is a species threatened with extinction, while Appendix 2 means species survival are threatened by trading rather than extinction. So trading activities need to be controlled. Of IUCN is to provide information and advice about the nature conservation to the public, while the purpose of site is to ensure international of wild animals and plants does not threaten their survival. We have 3 species Antago Batago species that list under IUCN and sites. First one is Batago affinis, Southern River Terrapin. Second is Batago basca, Northern River Terrapin. And the third one is Batago borneensis painted terrapin. All of them are listed under IUCN as critical endangered species. For Batago affinis and Batago basca, they have listed in sites appendix 1 since 1975, while for Batago borneensis, it is listed under site appendix 2 since 1997. They are all under conservation action under IUCN. The second content of my slide is the background of study, painted terrapin also known as the tuntung laut. The distribution is Borneo, Sumatra, Peninsula Malaysia and Southern Thailand. According to the Nor Carmilla in 2009, the river that holds the largest population of painted terrapin in Malaysia is Setiu River Terengganu, Pakar River Terengganu and Linggi River Negeri Sembilan. The reproduction of the painted terrapin is by oviparous, and the adult of the painted terrapin can achieve the average of straight carapace length is 50 cm. According to the IUCN, the population trend of Batago borneensis is unspecified, so the genetic approach is crucial factor for the conservation efforts for the highly threatened species such as Batago borneensis. And genetic approach also help in planning conservation program to increase the population of painted terrapin. COI gene is suitable for genetic marker because there are no other genetic region that can cover many taxa in taxonomically verified database. The third content of my slide is the problem statement. Batago borneensis is one of the big Asian turtle list in 25 world top endangered chelonians. They become endangered because of the overexploitation, habitat destruction, industrial and tourism development. The lack of research on painted terrapin population and distribution in Malaysia have been the reason that the population trend of Batago borneensis is unspecified. Thus, the primer that we will be isolate will be improving conservation strategy or programs of the painted terrapin. Objective, the first one is to isolate mitochondrial DNA region for painted terrapin. The second one is to isolate a species-specific COI primer for painted terrapin. And the third one is to verify the laboratory performance of species-specific primer based on COI gene for painted terrapin in controlled aquatic environment. There are 5 significant of study, which is academically, authorities, locally, economically and environmentally. For the academically, this study will fill in population and distribution research gap, because the latest research for the painted terrapin is conducted by Moll in 1990 only using museum specimen, visual confirmation by investigation or interviews and scientist literature. And the second one is to understand that the CUI primer design will help in Batago Borneo and Sis detection present without visual detection. For the authorities, this study also helped in provide framework for future laws or policies that will improve conservation program or strategy of Batago Borneo and Sis. For the locally, this study also will spread awareness about the endangered species to the citizen and encourage citizen scientists. For the economically, it will promote tourism such as in situ wetland where they have painted trapping sanctuary. For the environmentally, the study also will promote reserve area and lead to the stability of the ecosystem. The sixth content of my slide is my literature review. According to the Nor Carmilla in 2009, it described about the history of Batago borneoensis become critically endangered species. In 1982, Batago borneoensis has listed as the vulnerable species under the IUCN but changed to the critical endangered species in 1996. It is due to the depleting population due to the human activities and demand. The egg of the painted terrapin is considered as the aphrodisiacal properties and the meat was eaten by the adult. The human activities such as tin mining, deforestation and the water pollution also has been the reason the depleting of the distribution and population of the painted terrapin. And the lack of the research on painted terrapin distribution and population of Malaysia also have been the reason why we need to conduct this research. According to the Guntaro in 2012, this study has been take place in Aceh, Tamiang, Indonesia. He described that the Batago borneoensis has been in sites listed in the appendix 2 that zero quota for trading of this species. In this paper also state that the population of the painted terrapin have been decreased due to the hunter activities of their high price. And for my measurement method of this study, I refer also in this article to the procedure to measure the straight carapace length, straight maximum carapace width and the painted terrapin weight. For the COI gene isolation, I refer to the Bhaskar and Mohindra in 2018 for the universal primer of Batago borneoensis. The universal primer is to provide initiation site for the elongation of new DNA molecule as they can bind to the wide variety of DNA template and help in the designing species-specific primer for Batago borneoensis. In Lai by 2019, I refer to this paper for the procedure of the DNA extraction, DNA purification and the PCR process. And for Guntaro and Rianto in 2020, it showed that the molecular genetic study of the COI in improving conservation strategy is successful in Aceh, Tamiang, Indonesia. So, it'd be nice if we also use the molecular genetic study of COI to for the improving conservation strategy for Malaysia painted terrapin. Next, for my methodology, the first one is sampling. We will sampling Batago borneoensis in situ wetland sanctuary. The expected amount of sample is 40 juveniles from 10 nests, 4 juveniles in each nest by random. And then we will take the length of the carapace and the width. The second one is sample preparation and preservation. We will use the swab cotton to swab the inner part of the mouth of the Batago borneoensis to take their saliva and preserve in 95% of ethanol to extract the DNA later. Third one is DNA extraction. The sample preparation will undergoing several steps, which is lysis, protein removal, DNA binding, wash and DNA elution. DNA extraction is to isolate DNA from the saliva. And then it will go to the polymerase chain reaction, also known as PCR. In PCR, it will separate into two single-stranded DNA and synthesize two new strands of DNA using original strain as template. We will use also the universal primer for the cloning vectors that are able to bind to the wide variety of DNA templates. The fourth one is gel electrophoresis. Gel electrophoresis is to verify amplified DNA fragments by showing the molecule presence of DNA in the sample, and then we will go to the DNA sequencing. The DNA will send to the Apical Scientific SDN BHD laboratory for DNA sequencing service. The body size and weight of the painted terrapin will be examined using ANOVA one-way in the SL, and for the DNA sequencing, the DNA obtained will be inserted with the other Batago borneensis SOI sequence from the GenBank into the blast to confirm the species sequence. The seventh step of my methodology is the sequence alignment and editing. The DNA sequence will be aligned by cholesterol W to obtain the conserved region only for Batago borneensis. In this step, we will cut any noisy sequence such as the front, the back part, and the any gaps missing in the DNA sequence. We will compare the whole sequence and look any conserved region which is only Batago borneensis have it. Using the conserved part, we will make the species-specific primer for the Batago borneensis using Primer Tree software. Next, for my expected result, a species-specific primer COI gene is expected to be successfully isolated from the saliva of Batago borneensis. And then, the positive identification for species-specific primer is expected to be successful as the COI gene has high mutation rate to distinguish closely related species. The primer design will not be able to detect COI gene sequence of other species except for Batago borneensis only. And from this research, it is expected to be able to build accurate and functional database for further study in eDNA application. And this is my Gantt chart. The Gantt chart helped me to manage my research task. This is some of my reference that I used to make this presentation slide. Thank you. And if you have any question, please refer to the slide page and ask me. And that's all from me. Thank you again.